Okay, let's find the arc length of a function of y. Now, occasionally you'll get a problem like this where the y's are the inputs and the x's are the outputs. So we're trying to pass a horizontal line test if you want to test it for being a function. From the perspective of a physicist, you would just rotate your coordinate axes and use a function of x, so you wouldn't have to remember two different things. But most calculus books have these, so I'm going to do one. So what I'm going to do is a quick reminder, really quick reminder, of the theory behind the arc length formula. So I mark a little arc, a little section of arc, ds, and then I break it into components, dx and dy, and I see that ds is the square root. I think I'm going to back up. Square root of dx squared plus dy squared. Now, if you divide a dx squared out of the interior of the square root, you would end up with a dy dx, or an f prime, which is the ordinary arc length formula. And what we're going to do is go the other way, and we're going to pull out a dy squared, and I end up with dx dy all squared plus 1 dy. Now, this thing is an x prime of y. In other words, if you're given a function of y like this, and you differentiate, you're getting x prime of y. All right, so we're pretty much ready to start setting up the integral, and I need to get g prime of y, and that's going to give me, again, I'm differentiating with respect to y, not x, so that's going to give me just a simple cosine of y. So when I plug into the arc length formula, I get a dx dy squared, okay, so cosine squared y plus 1 dy, and then my entire arc length is going to be the sum of all those contributions to the arc length. So I'm adding up all of these guys, cosine squared y plus 1 dy, as y goes from 0 to 2 pi. Now, this is an integral that looks tempting, like we might be able to do it symbolically. All right, so here I've typed in the function into maxima, square root 1 plus cosine squared y, as y goes from 0 to 2 pi. So pi comes with a percent out in front in maxima. And I'm attempting to do this definite integral. And maxima just repeats the same integral back to me, which means this integral can't be done symbolically. So I'm going to use a numerical approximation. Quad QAG, it's a set of six different quadrature algorithms. That's just different ways of integrating numerically. You can choose whatever algorithm you want from 1 to 6. I don't think I've ever used number 5 before, so here it goes. All right, so I get an approximation of 7.64 out of this.